Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to TAPS Fall Soccer 2019. This will be our championship contest between First Baptist School of Brownsville and the Dallas International School. The Crusaders and the Tigers ready to take the pitch here momentarily at TAPS Fall Soccer 2019. Thank you for joining us for this contest on TAPS TV. We'll be coming to you live from Round Rock Multipurpose Complex in Round Rock, Texas. It's Dallas versus the Valley. Coming soon here on TAPS TV. Thank you again for joining us for Fall Soccer 2019. Momentary technical glitch here. Seems like the internet doesn't reach parts of Round Rock quite as well as it does other parts. As we move the table back 3 feet, we lost the signal, but we're back up now. Thank you for joining us for Taps Fall Soccer 2019 here on Taps TV. Again, we will have the Crusaders of Brownsville, our designated visiting team in white. They will have first touch. Our designated home team, Dallas International School, blue jerseys, red and blue on the front. We'll be ready to begin action shortly. Our keepers today, Jordan Keener, he will be defending goal for the Dallas International School, and Mauricio Valenzuela in the yellow on the far end. He'll be keeping goal for the Brownsville First Baptist Crusaders. Teams are ready. Referees are ready. We have the whistle. We have the first 40 minutes of our championship contest underway here in Round Rock, Texas. Ball played forward by the First Baptist. Challenge won by Dallas International. Both teams fighting hard for the ball right off the first touch. It's a chilly day here, but in contrast to yesterday, the wind has died a little bit. Benicia drives down the near sideline, sends the ball towards goal. Easy pickup that time by Valenzuela. Good challenge there on the far sideline. Throw in, won by First Baptist. Good job that time by number four. That's Hudson Rogers of Tigers. He wins the throw in. Looks like he'll take the throw in. Dallas International pushing forward on defense. Brownsville able to control, moving to the far side. That's number 21, Edgar Septian, trying to play ahead to tomorrow. Ball played ahead, number 9. Good job in the middle of the field by Herbrard. Gave him an opportunity. Good defense that time. Dallas International chasing the ball at the far side. Looks like we'll have our first corner of the day. Hands up. Ball's in the air. Played beautifully to the near side. Defense unable to clear. Ball still played in on the offensive end. Looks like the second corner is won again. 37-33, quick 3 minutes of action. They'll have another set piece on the far end. That's number 12, Martinez, putting the ball in play. Ball was headed all the way across. Attempting to clear, ball gathered by number 7. Number 7 is going to be Maimon. Maimon sends it back in towards the offensive middle. Salih able to get a hand on ball. Uncalled. Dallas International continues to push forward the middle. That was number 9 making the shot. Valenzuela easily up for the task.
And here's the ball, one back by First Baptist. Coming wide to this far side, that's number 6. That is Arciaga, who was very active in the semifinal yesterday.
Played the ball in deep to number 15, Victor Rivera. Victor Rivera unable to get a clean shot. Ball rolled across the goal mouth. Keeper punts to the middle. Good turn of field. Couldn't have done that yesterday, Will. Not with the wind we saw then.
Oh, no. The wind's a lot better today. Not as bad. Maybe 8 miles an hour.
Benicia makes the stab. Actually, Martinez now brings the ball up, shoots wide.
This is back to Chi out wide.
Chia keeps it in play. Out. He had nobody running on. I think he thought Martinez was going to take off with him. Martinez gives a late chase. First Baptist goes out with that one. Thought he might have returned it to the middle, but it will be a throw-in. Throw-in going to be taken this time by Dallas International. Going to be number 19 putting in the ball in play. That was Carlos Argudo. Al Gudo again, see which way he goes. He has Chia close. He chose to go deep.
Picked up by...
A lot of First Baptist hanging around number 12 that time.
All right, Martinez for the First Baptist picks it back up, taken away.
It's number 10. Good job that time.
Finding Arciaga in here in the middle.
Zerminio's been very active yesterday. Here comes Arciaga. Unable control. Martinez looks to go wide. He does. He sends it deep. Keeper calling off his defender. Again, Dallas International, all but two up near the mid. Arciaga to Amaro. Yesterday, that was quite the challenge. Here comes Amaro. Ball easily picked up by number seven for Dallas International, Levi Mimon.
Mimon with a clearing header, only gets as far as number eight. That is Navarre.
Navarre brings the ball back to his teammate. That's going to be number 15 on that far side again. There is Rivera. Good challenge. Good challenge again. Clean game so far. Number six, Arciaga. He was very active yesterday and controlled quite a bit. Ball goes back to number 10, Zerminio. It's stolen by Martinez. Martinez looks to play ahead. He had Chia on the run. Chia still on the attack. Good defense that time.
Ref calls a whistle. Chia was offside on that.
That was a good defense by number 19, Daniel Behar.
First 5 minutes, it's been all Dallas International. They've had a few opportunities, a couple corners. They've been on that side of the field most of the game so far.
Amaro here on the near sideline. See if he can get wide and find a little gap. Ball put in play straight down the middle. I think he thought he had number eight there. Navarre ready for a run. Navarre kind of watched the ball go over his head. Ball's reset out wide. Good job again. Number seven has been very active. Levi Mimon sends the ball to the middle. Ball won by number 10, Flavio Zerminio. Martinez clears. Now it's going to be a charge by number four. That's Hudson Rogers for the international school.
And a good clearance today by Esconuela of First Baptist. We've got a throw here. Quick throw back to Martinez. Played back in the middle. Picked up by First Baptist. With a nifty little back heel, keeping the possession going. Martinez steps in. This is Arciaga on the ball now. Ball swings wide here. Out here towards, and it's won back by First Baptist. This is Arciaga.
He looked like he was going to change with Amaro there. Plays ahead. That's number eight, Salee. Very active in the defensive backfield like yesterday.
Salee was extremely active and a lot going forward yesterday too.
He's an attacking, I don't even know what I'd call it. They have a sweeper behind him, so he plays more in the mid. Good challenge here. Good run on. Keeper picks up the ball. Tries to turn the field quickly with the punt. Martinez up to the task for international school. Ball's played back to the middle. They were looking for Chia, definitely right in the middle of the field.
A good clearance. Only it's as far as Martinez, though, but we have a whistle.
Quick stop of play. A little chatter between the players. The referee says, I've heard enough. Let's play ball. I think you're going to have those whistles when both teams are attacking for each possession.
Oh, yes. In a big-time game like this championship game, you're going to have chatter back and forth. It's going to be going back and forth for 80 minutes.
31-25 remaining here in the first half of play. There's that man, Chia. See what he can do with the ball. Chia returns to the middle.
That's Mimon on the ball now.
Mimon sends the ball deep.
Forward.
Thought he had a run on right there.
As far as the keeper, though.
Who was looking to go? It looks like it was number 10. Or is that 18? Well, I can't tell that far away. Spencer Gray was the one on the run.
Good punt.
There's Salee. Puts the ball to ground to Martinez. Tried to swing wide. Intercepted. We're going to have...
18 on the ball. Rivera.
Comes up to Zerminio. Unable to control. That was number 3 on the defensive end that time, it looked like.
got a international throw here.
DeShin.
We got a sub coming on.
It's going to be number 15 entering the pitch.
Pierre Ofopa. He had the winning goal yesterday.
Spencer Gray's exiting the pitch. So quick change there with 30 minutes and 25 seconds remaining here in Fall Soccer 2019's championship contest. The Crusaders of First Baptist School and the Tigers of Dallas International School.
A short throw here. This is Martinez on the ball now.
Sends the ball deep. He found a man in white, returned. There it is. That's going to be number 15, Ofopa.
He was offsides, though. Assistant referee caught it right away.
It's been a good job by the Brownsville First Baptist backline, Will, coming up.
They've had two offside looks
right there pretty quick.
You've been playing a very high line, not letting anything get behind them. That could very well be a major factor in this game.
Escanuelo with the kick, number four. See where he chooses to go.
He was looking for Amaro.
He finally finds Amaro in space. Amaro hasn't had many opportunities.
And that ball goes out. It will be a First Baptist throw.
It's going to be a quick throw in.
19 on the ball.
By number 19 is Behar. Behar looked for Amaro, unable to connect. That's number 17 for Dallas International. Levi Maimon, ball won by Amaro, tried to center. Good defense that time by number 6, Algudo. Arthur Algudo able to turn. Ball played ahead. Looking to the middle.
Chia had the ball but had a bad touch and gave it away.
Escanuela again came up, plays hard from that defensive end. This is number 8, Navarre. Plays wide to number 15, ball taken. By number 4, played ahead to Ofopa.
Ofopa with a great cut and coming back here towards the middle of the field. He keeps coming wide.
Dallas International continued to reverse field yesterday, and they do so again quite a bit today. I think the keeper probably should have called his man off on that one because it's going to result in a corner. It'll be the third corner.
It looks to be Martinez going out to take the corner.
We're 12 minutes in, 28 to go here in the first half. Martinez is going to take the shot, take the first corner from that side. There's been two of them from the far side. Now we're at the near side. See what he can do here. Yesterday, Dallas International continued to push Salee up. He's up, but he's outside the box at the present time, and he goes to the back side. Valenzuela has his defender set. Everyone's marked. No one on the near side, near post for International School. Ball played through. It's a good save.
Wow. With all the bodies in there.
They had number 10 on the back side. They had Bennett Chia for the opportunity, unable to connect.
Here comes Amar up the side. Ball played back through to the middle. Referee says play on.
That might be playing with fire if you're going to allow those corners. They're going to get it right sooner or later.
It's a good ball out here for Rivera.
Referee out to check. We'll see if we stop clock or play on.
Rivera looked to be getting up. He's back down for a moment. Looks to be
retied. Retie that boot. Get it on tight.
Check the shoelace. Be sure the shin guard's there. Be sure you're all good to go.
Children's Health Andrews Institute on site to take care of any injuries today. Not needed at this point. We appreciate their support. We appreciate Larry Lasky from Children's Health Andrews Institute being on site today. He did a good job taking care of our injured athletes yesterday. Throw in here for First Baptist. They go short. RCA able to keep in. It's a good fight over there. 21 is Septian for First Baptist. That's number 12, Martinez. He wins the throw, Will.
And this will be number 3, DeShin, throwing the ball.
Shin goes early and goes close.
Right back to the spot.
He gets it over the top.
This is Ofopa playing across.
Ofopa comes to the middle. You have number 9, Maimon. That's 10, Bennett Chia. He plays out wide to number 19. He gets it out to Algudo. Algudo to Chia. Ball tapped out that time by number 8, Navarre.
Referee signals a Dallas International throw. deep in their attacking third.
First Baptist may be lucky that was a throw, and if it had stayed in, it had been another corner.
It was going near the corner flag. Looks to be number 19 making the throw. That is Agudo.
Agudo's been very active up there. He's looking for Chia, I would imagine. Nope, it was Alfopa he was looking for. Chia stayed wide. Chia now with the ball.
Looking back to Agudo. Agudo trying to put the ball in.
Finally cleared. In the attacking front, you have both Chia and Alfopa both playing hard. Number 9, Maimon, is down there in the mix as well. Here on the backside, you have number 4. Number 4, Hudson Rogers, is kind of lingering right there in front of the goal if they can get it passed and come long.
He's out for another Dallas International throw right up against the corner flag. Looks short.
Good jostling. Excellent footwork that time to get free.
Assistant
but on the whistle, away we go.
Offsides.
Did he?
Yes, he did.
Far side.
Straight up.
Far side. Good look.
But, yep, and they thought it was a throw. Referee signaled for offsides.
.24-25 remaining here in the first half. We're 0-0. First Baptist Crusaders and the Tigers of Dallas International School. Feels like we've played an awful lot down there in that offensive end for Dallas International so far.
We really have. It's funny because yesterday all the gameplay happened on this right on the right side of the field, and there was nothing. There was very minimal action on that side.
Jordan Keener, the keeper for Dallas International, paces and waits. That's number 4 making the run on the near side on the side there. That was Hudson Rogers. Keeper Valenzuela covers quickly. Valenzuela tries to turn the field. Ball reaches mid. Maimon does a good job of bringing the ball to ground. Good job of playing in the air. Martinez now going to the right-hand side. Unable to beat his defender. Plays back to number 3. That was DeShin. Now the ball's played to Maimon.
And there's a foul. Ref was looking for advantage, but there was none to be had.
They were looking to play forward. Martinez again looks, scans the field. He has Alfopa and number 4, Hudson Rogers, to his right. He has Chia and Maimon in the middle. Goes deep, goes center, off target, but he did get an opportunity there.
Hey, Chia was right there, but the keeper was too fast to get to that ball with a punt out here to Amaro.
Amaro was busy yesterday. It runs all day long from that right-hand side. Ball played out wide. Good job of clearing back into the middle. That looks like
again,
offside again. Was that Chia?
No.
Nope.
That was Chia. Yes, it was. That was Chia.
Chia and Alfopa are playing awful far up. Defense is also coming up to meet them. Playing defense is much a learned skill as positioning, being in the right place at the right time.
If Chia and Alfopa can time those runs a little bit better, they could be in and they could find a one-on-one with the keeper.
Navarre brings the ball to play, sends the ball deep. Ball won by Dallas International School. Both teams with good footwork, able to dribble, but unable to dribble through the pressure. Number 4 intercepts that. That's Hudson Rogers. He plays forward.
Ball switched over here looking for Amaro. This is Zerminio on the ball now.
Zerminio plays forward to number 15. Number 15 is Rivera. He's been very active. They continue to go down that right-hand side, Will.
Ball played up, but
no one making a run on. Arciaga comes in late. Rivera comes in late. Ball played forward to Martinez. Martinez looking for Alfopa.
Martinez playing it deep.
I'll tell you what, the defender tried to head the ball out of danger.
Alfopa gets to it.
He gets to it on the far side. He centers.
Corner
he
far.
Has Chia down there with him. Chia looking to fight. It's number 19 giving defense there. That's going to be Behar.
Good
ball finally there. Cleared by number 21, Edgar Septian. Deep breath time that time for First Baptist.
That was a very dangerous moment right there for First Baptist.
First Baptist up front got ahead on the ball, but it ran past. Gave Alfopa an opportunity to run. Ball's played in near on the throw in. Ball's now centered. That's Maimon trying to dribble through. Good defense clears. Run given by Amaro. Amaro now at midfield. Good defense by number 7. Able to stop him. No whistle.
There's the foul.
We did have the whistle. Didn't have it immediately. I think he thought if he could get back up and keep running, he wouldn't blow the whistle.
Waited for a minute, but
advantage was lost when he couldn't control.
This is Septian on the ball now for the free kick.
Septian number 21 for First Baptist. Keener in goal.
Looks to be looking towards this far post over by 15.
Brings the ball straight in. That's number 7 again. Number 7, Levi Maimon. He's been a main defender here for the International School Tigers. Septian plays in. Number 6 heads it back out. That's Arthur Augudo. Unable to clear. That's Navarre. Navarre taps back to the side. Comes forward to Septian. Septian's being challenged by Chia. Chia makes the turn. Good right foot dribble to the outside. He's found the outside lane. Unable to keep it in. We have a flag up on the AR.
Quick throw here to Septian. Septian being defended by number 9. That's Havrard.
They definitely need to keep this ball in play. Amaro to the outside. You kind of knew they were looking that way. Number 19, Colas Augudo, stepped in the way. Number 12, Martinez, looking to come to the far side. He finds the run on by number 4. Hudson Rogers looks ahead to Alfopa. That's Alfopa, number 15. He turns and fires, but whistle had blown.
He is playing.
Looks like we were called offsides again. Does that look right over there on the?
Yes.
I think the flag did come up.
Yep, referee is signaling for offsides. That's been 4 or 5 different offsides calls.
Very consistent, though.
National team.
Very consistent. We've got number 4, Escanuelas, here to shoot the ball. See where he chooses to go. I think I'd go close to number 8, Navarre, maybe.
I'm playing it short right here because Dallas International has a lot of players.
Try to go over the top. Salih able to get boot on ball, unable to control.
This is Navarre on the ball on this far side. Up to Rivera. Rivera, to
Rivera
the
makes the turn this time.
Cross comes behind the goal.
Keener unchallenged yet. No shots on goal for First Baptist. They've been in the offensive third. 18-19 remaining in the first half. 18-19, nil-nil our score between Dallas International School and First Baptist from Brownsville. Keener puts the ball back into play. Ball played through by number 12, Martinez. Alfopa on the challenge. Chia unable to control, but Dallas International regains possession, plays forward. That time it didn't get to number 4. I thought he had a shot there. Hudson Rogers has been very active on that front end today. Quick throw in by the International School. Here's number 3, DeShin. Look to Alfopa. Ball played to the middle. Is that Maimon that tapped it wide?
This comes out to number 7. Maimon plays up now.
Looking here we go. We have a run on by Chia. Ball goes and scores,
offside.
But we have a flag up.
Called them offside.
Again had the run on.
That was a great opportunity there for Chia.
Was that Alfopa or Chia? I can't see from here.
Chia, I believe.
Excellent run on, but the flag again up. Keeper might have known that. Didn't give a whole lot of effort as he went left. Dallas International continues on the offensive challenge. Keeper has had his day so far. Official with the hand up. Esquinella, number 4, puts the ball back in play. Reverse
here.
Side here by the white. Our visitors try to control. Referee says play on. This is number 15, Rivera, down here in the near corner.
Cleared out.
Ball played out.
We'll go for a corner.
It will be a corner. It'll be the first corner of the day. See if they can get a shot off this time.
And it's number 8. That is Navarre going out to take the corner.
This will be their first set piece of the day, I believe.
But Rivera in, Arciaga in the box, Septian, and then Amaro is here at the back end, but they are very outnumbered here by the Dallas International defense.
I think First Baptist is a little worried about a counterattack. Referee says put the flag back, set your ball, then you can kick. We have 16:25 remaining in our first half. Navarre with the kick. Sends the ball high, right good in the ball. Middle. Good job to head that ball out by number 6. That was Arthur Augudo. Blade out wide to Algudo.
Up the line.
Alfalfa, he's able to keep it in. Flag goes up. Looks like we'll have a substitution.
Not yet. That was a First Baptist throw. Rivera trying to turn, unable to.
Salee clears to the front. Chia plays the ball wide to number 19. He and Algudo go left. Chia giving chase. Ball goes out. Be a throw-in for Dallas International School.
Here comes the sub.
Number 25 is going to be our substitute, Andrew Ward. Looks like he's entering the pitch for number 10, Bennett Chia.
Chia's been very active in this first half, but he's had a couple of good shots, including finding the back of the net, but because he was offside, it did not count. We'll see if Ward can do a little bit here.
Ward has a little more height. It looks like they're stacking it up on the front end. See what they can do, see if they can earn. They look forward into the corner. Ball headed back out by First Baptist. Another throw in. Quick throw that time by by Dallas International. Able to clear. Goes off the side.
Got another First Baptist, Dallas International throw.
I think Dallas International has walked it up just like they wanted to. They're looking for that next set piece.
Short throw here. This is
Alfopa.
Played inside here. Picked up by First Baptist.
Good job by Martinez. Martinez has done a good job in the middle of keeping pressure on. Here we come to this side over here. Amaro's making a run. Unable to get there as number six taps the ball out. Number six is Arthur Algudo. He's been side to side on defense as well. He's swept well. 14-14 remaining here in the first half of a tie game. 0-0. First Baptist School from Brownsville and Dallas International School. We're going to have number 21, Septian, with the throw in. Scans the field. Continues to look aggressively forward. Got the ball to Amaro. Now Arciaga.
Picked up by Martinez.
Martinez turns. Good attack there from the back end by number 5, Arciaga. Number 12, Martinez again throws the ball forward. That's Spencer Ward, Andrew Ward, rather, trying to move the ball ahead. Number 25 for the Tigers. A lot of contact, a lot of feet get tangled. A lot of the same colors with each other. Here comes Salee. Salee plays the ball forward, unable to clear. 21, Septian plays wide to Amaro. Amaro looking to turn the corner, still looking to turn the corner. Ball played in deep off the end line. Who's it off of?
And it will be a goal kick.
Goal kick forthcoming. Amaro continues to turn. Good job, but he can't quite get that right foot to get that ball to come across. This is going to be number 6, Arthur Algudo, with the shot.
First Baptist has had a lot better opportunities coming up their left side to cross the ball and down this right side.
That was a good job to play that ball through that time. That was number 9, Charles Hebrard.
Here's a Fupo, he is onside.
He does onside, and he does have a run, and it's a shot, and it's a goal. Number 15. Number 15 with the shot, 15 with the goal. That brings our score to 1-0, Dallas International School.
Back with the kick. First Baptist on the ball.
Quick restart that time after the score. Dallas International again wins possession. Quick throw in here. Looking for Martinez. Martinez seems to be that field general directing him forward. Ball played forward. Chase given by Andrew Ward, number 25. It'll be a throw in. Number 19, Colas Algudo, looking with the throw. This whole backside looks to be waiting for the ball. they continue to throw forward.
Versus Baptist here tries to clear, but only gets as far.
That's number 12, Martinez in the center. Sends in a shot from deep on the outside. Ball goes high. Valenzuela was there, but the ball crashes off the crossbar.
It was a great shot, but I think keeper would have had it covered. He, with his vertical, he had his hand over the goalpost. I think it wouldn't have been a problem for him. It's a good shot, though.
Approaching 11 minutes to play here in the first half. Dallas International 1, First Baptist 0. Attacked that time by 19. He throws the ball in deep. Looks like Alfopa again was the challenge. Chia was the challenger from that near side all the first part of this game. Now that he's out, they've moved Alfopa over to that side.
It'll be a First Baptist throw. Trying to discuss who's going to take the throw.
Dangerous little throw from deep in their end of play.
You can't give the ball away here. It's a very bad area.
Players get tangled up. They say play on. Flag up. Flag gives possession to Dallas International. Both ARs in good position.
This is Arciaga. Driving across the field.
That was number 4. Rogers able to gain possession momentarily. Martinez comes forward. Good challenge by Navarro this time, number 8.
Navarro keeps driving down this far side. Picked up, only got as far as number 4.
Arciaga, this might be the best opportunity yet. They're able to clear.
A good booming clearance.
Was that number 6, Arthur Algudo?
That was Arthur Algudo.
Number 19 plays the ball forward. Here we come with number 19 on this side. Septian tried to play forward tomorrow. Ball played out by number 7. Levi Mamon's been very active on this defensive end. First Baptist, every time they come down our left-hand side.
Here's 21 for the throw. This is Septian. Looking. He's got Amaro and Navarre showing for him. Morrow making a run.
He looked to make that corner. I think he's trying to play to space, don't you?
Absolutely.
Ball is turned and played forward to Alfopa.
Alfopa finds some space in front of him. Plays it wide.
That was a good job on the defense to turn him.
Algudo,
now he's on the charge. Flags down, so he is onside. See what they can do. That was Garza giving defense as well. He had the man checked behind him.
Nothing to do there.
8:55 remaining in the first half. Goal kick. Who's going to take that goal kick? Is that going to be number 4?
That is number 4.
It is number 4, Escanuela. Not sure where he'll go. He plays the ball forward looking for Septian. Septian able to get boot on ball, brings it to ground. Back to Septian, see if he can turn this corner. He does, but sends the ball sailing wide. Amaro was unmarked. If he could have brought that ball back inside the line, I think Amaro had a run. The only one behind him was number 6. It would have been Amaro and Algudo.
Looks like there's a substitute coming here for Dallas International in a moment.
We have a player going off. It's going to be number 19. Number 19, Colas Algudo, exits the pitch. Looks like number 20. It is number 20. It's going to be Eduardo Silva entering the contest for the Tigers.
Actually, that was number 15, Afopa, the goal scorer who came off. He's making his way around the left side goal.
Jogging quite well under his own power.
Must have just been a tactical change, try to get them into the half up 1-0, give them a little bit of rest the last 7.5 minutes of the first half.
Ball cleared out wide by Zerminio.
This will be Algudo on the throw again. But another sub here. Chia is coming back on for Ward. Ward's coming off, number 25.
You got a good 7 or 8 minutes of rest. But this is another attacker. You take number 15, Alfopa, off. You're able to get Chia back on. You've got two very aggressive players there, one in basically for the other after a quick change.
To the Dallas International coach, he seems to always want either Chia or Afopa, at least one of them on the field at all times for a good attacking, for a good striker up top. Ball cleared ball there.
Ball cleared. 6:45 remaining in the first half. First Baptist nil. Dallas International Tigers 1, 6:39 remaining in the first half of play. It's a chilly morning. Don't think the temperature's risen much above 50, but compared to yesterday, the winds have now changed from the south-southeast at about 8 instead of the north-northwest at 20 to 25. So conditions are much more favorable to playing today.
Definitely feels a lot better here at calling this game, too.
Looks for the throw. Looks for Chia.
Just over Chia's head, picked up by First Baptist. Looking for...
There's Maimon, number 7, looking to keep it in the offensive end. He'll get the throw in. See where he's looking to go. First Baptist playing the balls well in the air, but unable to really control after they make the header. Arciego looks to Septian. Septian looks to push the ball wide. Now right down the middle. Rivera thinks better of it, reverses field. Brings the ball back to the middle to Septian. Septian plays down to this corner.
Looking. And there is a foul.
There is a foul called. Aggressive play by both players.
On Navarre.
Arciego and Navarre playing the ball forward. On the backside, you have Arciego and you have Amaro. On the front side, you have Rivera and Navarre, number 21, Septian with the kick.
If I'm First Baptist, I'm looking to this far post where Arciego and Amaro are. Or that he may even look to have a shot from this distance, about 30 yards out.
He's got number 10 walking on. He had Flavio Zerbino right there to walk on. Ball was played back out.
But a whistle called offsides.
Flag was up quickly. Good job by our ARs today. There hadn't been a lot of the calls have been made, but they've been made quickly, in a timely fashion, not letting them run on pass. So the flag was up. Ball put back into play by number 6, Arthur Algudo. That's Chia giving chase. Chia was able to get his boot on ball, able to control. He has number 4, Hudson Rogers, running on the near side. Looked to play back to Martinez, unable to connect. Martinez gives chase. Looks like Rivera again on the near side. Nope, that was 8, Navarre. Ball cleared by Algudo. Navarre continues to press the action.
It's a 21,
Septian with the throw. He goes close to Rivera. Rivera tries to tap through. Ball's cleared again by number 3, Destashin. See where Septian goes this time. He went near. He went to Rivera. Tariq Salih clears. This is number 16, Amaro, picking up the ball. 16 looking to make the turn. Little contact. Good clear that time by number 7.
And we've got a First Baptist throw. Amaro looks a little shaken up.
I think it's that same foot he got shaken up or stepped on with yesterday.
He had to leave the game for about 20 minutes yesterday across the game.
That was Levi Maimond on the last line of defense, number 7, with the tap out.
Yep, he seems to be favoring that right foot just a little bit.
Coach doesn't have anybody up.
I think it's only a matter of time before he brings someone in.
Good attack this time by Zerminio. Ball cleared by number 6, Algudo.
This will be a corner, and this looks like 15 will be taking it.
15 is going to be Rivera. Two on the near side, two on the back side. First Baptist keeps a few more hands back on the back end. Amaro comes forward as well. So you'll have Amaro and you will have Flavio Zerminio on the near side. In the middle, Arciega, 21 Septian and number 8 Navarre on the backside. Ball comes up, ball comes high. Keeper able to take care of business there. That was Keener, able to control the ball. He looks to reverse the field. He punts to the right. The only one out there was Chia, but he's more than willing to take and accept the pass. He looks to turn and go. He moves forward to Hebrard. Hebrard to Chia. Brownsville First Baptist defense was up to the task. Ball cleared by number 6. That's Algudo, Arthur Algudo. 1:45 remaining in the first half. 1:45 remaining in this first half of play of Taps Fall Soccer Championship. This is our championship contest. Dallas International 1, First Baptist of Brownsville 0.
A good ball through here for Amaro. Just can't get
cleared again by Maimon. Number 19 puts the ball to ground. Colas Algudo looked to move forward. They're looking for Amaro. Amaro unable to catch up to the ball.
We've got two subs coming on for...
One of them is Enzo McGregor, number 21.
And the other is number 5. That is Christopher Granberry. Coming off was number 4, Hudson Rogers. And number 19, that's Colas Algudo.
Granberry yesterday played back in the back end, did a good job for the Tigers.
Granberry was very active yesterday, had a few good
Dallas players. International had the chance to turn and run, unable to control.
Quick throw here for Germino on the turn, beats.
Ball's played forward to number 12, Martinez. See if First Baptist can clear. Martinez pushes the ball out wide. He finds number 5, Granberry. That's number 15 for Brownsville, giving chase, able to control.
And Rivera wins the ball back from Granberry. Cleared by Granberry for a First Baptist throw here.
We have 15 seconds remaining here in the first half. 15 seconds remaining in the first half of play. We're under 10. I think the clock will run before we have another offensive opportunity. The half will end on the horn. And we do have the horn. We thank you for joining us here for Taps Fall Soccer 2019, our championship contest. At the half, International School Tigers 1, Crusaders of First Baptist Brownsville 0. We'll have a 10-minute halftime, and then we'll be back for the second half and the conclusion of our championship contest.
Aiden loves playing baseball. He's in his element when he picks up a baseball bat.
When Aiden tore his ACL last year, we were all devastated. We didn't think that a 13-year-old could have a problem such as that.
Children's Health Andrews Institute for Orthopedic and Sports Medicine not only repaired Aiden's ACL, but they gave him the knowledge and skills to prevent any future injuries.
Now, less than a year later, he's back to hitting homers and doing phenomenal.
I think that high school sports have made me physically and mentally tough. Sports have taught me through good times and bad times that you have to keep your head up and stay tough and keep working harder to get better.
School team is family. Traveling team, they also still family. But once you finish the season, we all split apart. We don't ever come during the season together unless we compete against each other. But other than that, school team is like, it's family to me. And I consider that a prized possession.
Thank you again for joining us here for the Fall Soccer Championships of 2019. We're in Round Rock, Texas at the Round Rock Multipurpose Center. It's a turf field. It's 40 degrees. The wind's picked up to about 10 miles an hour. Both teams have played well. Brownsville First Baptist, 2 shots on goal, 2 corner kicks. No points, no score, 0 on the scoreboard. Dallas International, 7 shots on goal. They have 3 corner kicks and a score by number 15. Number 15 is Pierrick Alfopa. Our score, 7:31 remaining in the halftime. Dallas International Tigers 1, Brownsville First Baptist Crusaders 0. Thank you for joining us on Taps TV.
I play basketball and softball. Basketball is more just like that sport, like I just can't give up because like I've always loved it also. It's just not my best sport. I love the girls on the team and I just enjoy the sport in general. And it's good to get like a break from softball. If I don't want to get burned out from it, because when I get that 2-month, 3-month break playing basketball for my high school, it gives me time to like really miss it. And then so when I come back, I'm like ready to go and like wanting to work even harder.
One minute left in our halftime as we approach the second half. Taps Fall Soccer Championships 2019 here at the Round Rock Multipurpose Complex. Temperatures come up a little bit, but the winds also come up with a little bit, this time from the southeast. Winds probably 10 to 15 at this point. The flags are pointing to the north end. Means Dallas International in blue will have the wind at their face as they defend the far goal. On the near goal, First Baptist Brownsville in white, they'll have the wind, slight wind at their back. Valenzuela, the keeper for First Baptist. Keener, the keeper for Dallas International as we approach the second half of play. Dallas International should bring us into play here in the second half. That's Chia in the middle. See where he decides to begin play. We have number 14. That's Blanca Pinaloza entering the contest in the middle for Brownsville First Baptist. Zerminio number 10 and Navarre number 8 up front. Number 6, Arciaga. Number 21, Septian. All looking to make an attack. After the ball back, here comes Dallas International. Pinaloza giving a track. Ball played forward. Chia unable to control. Ball comes back to Arciaga, number 5. He plays to the right-hand side to number 19. Number 19 is going to be Daniel Behar. He plays ahead to Amaro. Amaro wins the play. Navarre as well. Navarre, number 8, played not deep enough. Tries again. Finally makes contact with Amaro. Pinaloza going forward. Referee signals play on. That's Chia. Chia returns to the middle of the field. He's got number 12, Martinez. Martinez clears to the far sideline. It's number 20, McGregor. 21, Septian moves the ball out wide.
First Baptist has a lot of good possession right now, but they just can't. Oh, and as I say that, they give the ball away. And here
comes Chia. He makes the run. He's onside. He still has the ball.
Tries to cut back.
He has number 12, Martinez, in the middle. Plays the ball back deep. Ball played high. That's Garza. Garza unable to clear. Again unable to clear. Chia holds the ball in. He and Martinez. Martinez looks to make the turn on the corner. That's number 8, Navarre, playing the ball out to the side. For Dallas International on the throw-in right here in front of us, we'll have number 20. That's going to be Eduardo Silva and Chia on the back end, Granberry. Martinez with the throw. He was looking for number 9. Unable to make that connection. He looked for Hebrard. He and Hebrard have been very active together today, Martinez, etc. Pinaloza with the ball.
Trying to cut back, lost out.
Hebrard with the steal.
Pinaloza back on the ball and back to Granberry.
Granberry able to take that one.
Salee on the ball looking for Martinez.
Finds him, good defense, good offense, good tussle that time.
Zerminio in there fighting for the ball but draws a foul, so it will be a Dallas International free kick right at halfway.
He's got his options. He's got Granberry to the left and onside, it looks like this time. For right now, it's Chia. AR is in a direct line. He's got the best look. Ball's played up and high. Everybody's on. Keeper comes out.
Chia chasing down for the
ball. Didn't have to do that. Didn't have to do much work there. That's Navarre bringing the ball down. Ball's played to side to Septian. Septian continues on the outside. Arciaga looks to play back to him. There's Salee. Salee plays forward to Granberry. That was number 4, Escanuela.
This is Granberry on the ball looking to cross.
Granberry makes the cross. Number 29, Garza, plays the ball out for a corner.
There's a good defensive play there by Garza because he had a couple different Dallas International forwards coming in towards the goal. If he wasn't there, that ball could have come across the face of the goal. And who knows what would have happened from there.
Number 20 retrieves the ball, but it looks like it's going to be number 12, Martinez. David Martinez, number 12 for Dallas International School with the kick from the corner. Dallas International floods the zone. You have number 20. That's Eduardo Silva on the near side. You have Granberry on the near side. You have number 9, Hebrard, on the near side. It does go to Granberry. Ball's able to be cleared by Arciaga, played back in. There's Hebrard. Number 20, Silva.
Was offside.
Offside. Saw a lot of hands go up at the same time, so if it wasn't offside, it was probably going to be hand.
Say, about half the First Baptist defensive line was calling for them to be off as well, so.
Esquinella sets the ball. 35-45 remaining here in the second half of play. Dallas International School Tigers 1, Brownsville First Baptist and Crusaders 0.
Good kick there into Navarre. Back to Zerminio.
Dallas International continues the attack. That was number 12, Martinez. He was looking for Chia. Here comes Herbard, number 9.
This is Chia now on the ball. Looking to cut back. Has Herbard in the area.
She is very active on both sides of the pitch. He doesn't care which side he comes from. He finds Herbard. Herbard in the middle. Herbard was looking to get a shot, unable to do so. Martinez. There's number 12, Martinez. Martinez will take the shot. He went to the far side.
Went well wide.
Well wide of the post.
That'll be a goal kick for Valenzuela.
That's one of the first times that Chia has not come forward. He might have had a shot on that back side, but he didn't come far enough up. Good defense that time by the Crusaders. Esquinella, number 4, puts the ball in play. Goes directly down the middle. Herbard with the head. Silva coming back on, giving chase for Dallas International. Number 10, Zerminio plays forward to Peñaloza. Peñaloza plays the ball forward looking for Amaro. That's number 19 sending the ball deep. That was Daniel Behar. Peñaloza has been very active out there in the mid. See what opportunity Brownsville First Baptist can play. Peñaloza, good defense that time, brings the ball back forward by Martinez. Martinez sends the ball in deep. He has Chia running on. That's number 5, Arciaga, with the defense, unable to clear to the side. It'll be another corner.
Dallas International has 2 players ready to come on, just awaiting the referee's instructions.
It's going to be number 15, Alfopa. And it's going to be number 11. That's going to be Edward Ulbrich.
They appear to be letting the corner take place first before the subs.
Martinez, 12, sets the ball. Near side, Silva, Chia, Granberry. Backside, Salih. Salih comes forward to the near post now, moving in close to the goal. Ball sent forward to him. Header taken by Herbard. Not sure who that was for. Salih was there. Herbard stepped in front.
Good opportunity there for the Tigers. Just couldn't capitalize on it.
Here come our – they allow the subs on. They do, looked like they were motioning them on. Chia's going off. Silva's going off. Coming on, Ulbricht and Alfopa. Alfopa being the one scored today. Our score, Dallas International 1, Brownsville First Baptist 0, as we approach 32-30 to play in the second half. Esquinalito sends the ball into play deep down the right-hand side. Controlled by Dallas International. That's Herbard.
Out for a
ball slides out. Looks like it'll be a throw. Dallas International is doing a good job of moving side to side. It seems like the Brownsville attack, whichever side they start on, they kind of continue down that side. Good attack given by Amaro. Ball cleared. No one on the backside. Granberry will control for Dallas International. Granberry sends the ball forward to number 15, Alfopa. Alfopa turns, reverses field. He's got number 4. It's number 11, Ulbrich. Good job by keeper Valenzuela. He turns the field, goes to 6. That's Arciaga. Arciaga has Peñaloza in front of him. Peñaloza turns to run to the left. He finds her. Blanca turns, cleared by the defense.
This Dallas International defense will not let anything get by them today.
They were all inside. They had Amaro on the far side and Zerminio as well. Just couldn't get it connected. Ball played wide by Zerminio. Here comes Arciaga dribbling down the front. Salit takes the ball to ground.
Looks for a foul, and it will go.
Foul is called.
That's Arciaga working his way back up.
You think he'll play short or take the shot here? This is going to be number 21, Septian. Septian looking to seat.
Well, going into that direction, he does have the wind behind him, so a shot wouldn't surprise me, but I would look more across towards that far post.
He's got Arciaga in the middle. Zerminio a little bit out high, squared up. Amaro on the far side, and Peñaloza, that's where he's going, to Peñaloza. Good stop that time. Good stop by the keeper, Keener.
Stop the clock. We've got player down.
Player down for First Baptist. Children's Health Andrews Institute. Larry Lasky, our trainer today, looking to see if he needs to make his way out. He does not. Peñaloza pops back up.
Back up. All good.
As the clock was stopped, we do have to make a change, I believe. Blanc is going to head to the sideline. Number 22 for First Baptist entering the contest. 22 is Jose Gonzalez. Might have been Keener's first real test. Had an opportunity there.
As we get going here, just at 3:30 left, 30 minutes, 30 seconds left in this game. It's a 1-0 lead for the Dallas International Tigers over the Crusaders from First Baptist of Brownsville.
That's number 5, Granberry, with the throw in. Went short to Alfopa. Arciaga with the turn. Navarre looking to challenge. He lets Arminio try to play through. Unable to do so. It looks like Hebrard with the ball. He's playing forward. He has Alfopa. Flag was up. Flag was up. And Valenzuela was waiting. Flag was up immediately. All three defenders also helped to indicate that he was offside.
It's a good quick call by the assistant referee on this near side.
From our vantage point, I appreciate them being – it's when they make a quick call, everybody knows, instead of just waiting to see where they play on. It's much appreciated. Good job today by our officials. Good job in all three games by the officials. Esquinella, number 4, sends the ball deep. Picked up by Navarre, number 8. Navarre challenged by number 11 that time. Good job by
– the football coming in. He is on.
Albrecht. Albrecht is onside. He shoots wide.
Ball was never going towards goal.
No one came from the backside that time. Martinez started with him and then pulled back up. He didn't have much choice but to shoot that himself. 28-52 remaining here in the second half. 28-52 remaining in our contest. Dallas International Tigers 1. Crusaders of First Baptist 0. Ball sent forward. Brought back into the offensive end by the Tigers. Tigers play through. That was number 5, Cesar Arciaga. Clearing. Number 8, Navarre, moves forward to clear. They continue to look at Alfopa, looking at his opportunities. The Crusaders come back in defense. They've marked each man. Ball looks to go deep to Hebrard. Ball is played to the middle of field, number 22, now number 6. Number 6 is Arciaga as he drives forward. He finds Amaro. Amaro has a run on. He's onside. It's he and number 7 one more time. That's number 7, Levi Maimon.
Amaro
and Maimon.
Advantage played.
Plays it through, cleared.
Only as far as Navarre.
This time Septian on the left-hand side. Ball stoned by Martinez. Martinez takes it. Alfopa is onside. Alfopa, good challenge here by Arciaga. Good job by the keeper to stop that shot.
What a save right there.
Excellent save that time.
Good sliding challenge there by Martinez, leading to a throw-in for First Baptist. Valenzuela was not going to let that ball get by him.
That might have awakened some spirits here. That was a good challenge by Alfopa. Valenzuela was up to the task for Brownsville. Ball played wide by Zerminio. Number 19 coming on the challenge here. That's Behar.
Dallas International defense lets the ball roll back to the keeper unharmed. Looking to punt now.
They continue to look to Amaro on the far side of the field. Ball played through. Alfopa unable to bring the ball to ground. Navarre does. Navarre plays wide out here to number 19. See what we can start here from Daniel Behar. Behar plays ahead to Amaro, but Amaro is marked well by the Dallas International defense. This ball is played through. Alfopa is giving chase. Alfopa and number 11, Edward Ulbricht, were giving chase that time.
Garza got to it with little effort, though.
Looks like Chi is back up over there, Will, so it may be time for a change. Dallas International clears. Looks like number 10, Zerminio. This time, Hebrard, he was looking for Alfopa. Number 11 giving chase, Ulbrich. There's Hebrard again. Little confusion in the middle brings the whistle. First Baptist will have possession. Looks like we have multiple subs.
Got it. Including one from First Baptist who appears ready to come on. Just waiting for the referee to signal.
First Baptist is going to be number 7, Will. That's going to be Pedro Silva, very active yesterday. Number 13 is going to enter the pitch for the Tigers. That's Anna Castellanos. Bennett Chia.
Another goal for First Baptist. First Baptist ties it up with just that 25-22 left in the game.
As substitutions are made, our score with 25-22 remains 1-1 in this championship contest.
Six. Man has been active all day long, and including yesterday, finally finds the back of the net and ties it up here with 25-22 left in the game. Good on Arciaga for finding the back of the net there.
Alfopa here on the challenge on here. He has an excellent run on by Chia. They've got both strikers in now, Will. They're going to turn up the heat, I think, for Dallas International. Dallas International wins the throw in. It's going to be Granberry. He's got Alfopa close. He has Chia in the middle. Hebrard up top and Martinez. Granberry surveys the field, goes short to Alfopa.
Get the ball inbound.
Granberry sends it in deep, but it goes out without challenge off the end line.
Ref looking for sub. Yeah, another sub here for Dallas International. 21 is coming off. That's Enzo McGregor.
We have number 19 entering the pitch and number 4.
And 4 is coming on for number 5. 5 of Chris Granberry. Hudson Rogers coming off.
So we have Hudson Rogers, Colas Augudo return to play. We have number 10, Zerminio, down on the near sideline here. He'll go off.
And it looks to be 21 who came back on.
Septian returns to the pitch. Escanuela sends the ball out. Good challenge. Amaro looks energized. He's able to turn the corner on number 7, Maimon, this time. Good challenge by Maimon. Amaro, Arciaga.
Easily collected there by Jordan Keener. Keener looking for and just offers the punt. Booming punt. One back by First Baptist, though.
Martinez giving chase. She is returned back to the middle.
Foul here.
Whistle blows.
Arciaga is the one who went down.
Number 22, Jose Benavides. Ball will be put into play by number 7, Pedro Silva. See what magic he can bring off that right foot. Sends the ball in deep.
This is Alfopa on the ball now.
Alfopa on the charge. ESG in the middle. Good job that time to return. Number 19 chases the ball down. That's Daniel Behar. Ball kept into play by number 11, Ulbricht. Here's Alfopa and Chia both fighting. See who controls. It's Chia.
Ball.
Good defense by Escanuela. He sends the ball out wide.
Great slide.
Behar
challenge.
Looks to clear but cannot. Ball comes back forward by Hebrard. Hebrard plays to the left to number 4.
Martinez.
Number 4 sends the shot, but it's going to miss the goal, go out to the right-hand side. That was a good offensive opportunity. Dallas International pushing everybody forward.
Here as we go, just under 22 minutes left in this game. It's First Baptist 1, Dallas International 1.
Number four, Enrique Escuela. See where he chooses to go. He's got this backside over here if he chooses to go that way, but it looks like he's looking forward to Behar. Yep, he went to Behar, missed him. It'll be a throw-in for Dallas International. Dallas International continues on the offensive hunt. Behar wins the ball. Up front to Amaro. Amaro making a run. He has number 22 up there with him. Number 22 is Jose Gonzalez.
Jose Gonzalez on the ball now, looking across.
He has Arciaga, but unable to bring the ball down. He gets the ball to ground. Good defense as they battle. He was looking to center. That's Garza moving forward.
Chia gets there first.
Hebrard. Hebrard comes to the inside. Good ball played forward by 21 Septian. Ball played out wide to number four. Hudson Rogers unable to control. Number 21. See who's going to throw this in out there, Will. It looks like 21 Septian again. He's got number eight, Navarre, and he's got number six. He chooses to go to 22. Ball's turned by Arciaga. Whistle is blown. See how quick he pops up. Looking for this offensive opportunity. 20 minutes, 20 seconds remaining here in the second half. We're all tied up at 1-1 at the Taps Fall Soccer Championships here in Round Rock, Texas. The Tigers and the Crusaders continue to attack the goal. See who will take this kick.
And the kick, waiting for the referee's signal. Here it comes. Okay, going far post, too far, going out for a goal kick.
Little too much adrenaline on that one. Getting ready to put the ball back into play.
Ball coming in, picked up by...
Is that Hebrard or was that Martinez?
It was Hebrard playing it wide here to number four. That's Hudson Rogers on the ball. Up to
Alfopa coming in. He's making the challenge. Navarre came in from behind, unable to get it free.
Slow roller to Valenzuela, easily picked up.
Valenzuela able to make the stop. Chia was a little slow coming. Punt clears Hebrard. See if we can keep it into play. We don't do. Number 22. Was making his attack.
Foul called. That was Amaro. Looks a little shaken up. He's walking fine.
Number 22, Jose Gonzalez, has done a good job of bringing energy to the front end up there. He's been attacking it ever since he had entered the pitch. Looks like the ball will be put into play by number seven, Pedro Silva. He was active yesterday and did a good job. Let's see where he's planning on going this time. He chooses to go right down the middle.
Coming wide here. Back to Arciaga, who gets through.
He had Navarre waiting. Ball played to number seven. Silva, he takes the shot.
Ball was
curves left. He had a pretty good spin on that ball off his boot.
Good booming throw.
Here's Hudson Rogers. He brings the ball to ground. Garza for the defense. Moves the ball forward to to Septian. Now the ball is won by Hebrard. Hebrard plays the ball through. This is going to be Chia. The ball was cleared by Arciaga. See what Hudson Rogers can do. He puts the ball into the air. Attacked by Alfopa. The keeper's way off his mark on this one. Alfopa unable to control quickly, though. Valenzuela able to recover to the near post. Here comes Hudson Rogers. Ball sent forward. It's Navarre. Navarre making a run with Arciaga. It's number 22 sitting in the middle waiting. And you have Amaro on the far side if they can reverse. Arciaga sees him. He sends it to 22. 22 takes his time on the turn. He had Amaro on the run.
Off the turn coming here to the far side here for number 10.
That's number 11. Bring the ball out, Ulbrich. Ulbrich looks for Chia. Alfopa looks to be onside if he can turn. Alfopa was calling for it. Flag's up. Flag is up.
He's off. As he was making the run, he was looking over towards the AR. He knew he was off.
I think after that first half, they were offside several times. They're starting to look now to figure out where they are. Valenzuela is marking his men well. He's continuing to talk to his defense, gets him in the right place.
Got 16 and a half more minutes here left in this game, 1-1 at the time.
They're going to have to be very careful with Chia and Alfopa both up front. They're both playing that two-striker attack in the middle. Ball goes wide looking for Amaro. Amaro unable to control. Ball sails out of bounds. We're going to have a throw-in for the Tigers from Dallas International School. 16 minutes remaining. 16 minutes remaining in the second half of this championship contest here from Round Rock, Texas. Quick throw backwards. They reset the field. Coming back to the near side. Ball sent forward. Navarre picks up the ball. Pushes it up to number 7, Silva. It's Navarre looking to control to Amaro. Here comes the attack by Dallas International School. That was number 12, Martinez, bringing it. Now it's Abrard. Ball goes wide to number 4, Hudson Rogers.
Good ball here.
Roger plays through to Alfopa. Alfopa looking for Chia. Chia's looking to redirect. Here comes the shot.
And just wide,
by Martinez. Excellent teamwork, excellent passing to create that offensive opportunity.
Looks to be a substitute coming on here for First Baptist. It will be Zerminio in for Silva.
Both Zerminio and Silva have been active today. That was a good job by Dallas International School and an excellent job on defense as well. They play the ball out wide to number 19, Behar. Behar able to move forward. Danger zone here with Alfopa. Alfopa and Garza. Alfopa, if he can chase it down, will maintain possession. He does. On the sideline, dribbles past. Dribbles around number 4, Esquinuela. Sends the ball in. Keeper calls his man off, makes an easy pickup. 14 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in regulation. Our score 1-1 between the Tigers and the Ambassadors. I'm sorry, the Crusaders. Attack by Herbard, stopped by number 21, Septian. He goes up to Arciaga. Arciaga back to Septian. Navarre gets tired of that, sends it out wide. Esquinuela giving chase to Alfopa. Alfopa back to Hudson Rogers. He does not make the run, so it'll be an easy pickup for First Baptist. First Baptist, Esquinuela looks to send the ball to Arciaga. That was number 4. Whistle was not blown as they had advantage. Little contact out there on the far side. Ball sent to the middle. Keeper looked to come out. It was a good clear by the defense. Behar runs it down.
Stays in bounds, though. This is picked up now by number 19 of First Baptist.
That's Behar. He continues to be challenged out there on that side. That's Amaro coming all the way back to pick up the ball. Navarre now. Ball goes out wide. That's going to be number 10, Chia, with the throw in. He has 11. Ulbrich to the near side. He goes that way. Sorry, that was number 19. A little difficult to see from our angle. That was 19, Colas Algudo. Valenzuela with the pickup. Valenzuela with the punt. He sends it out towards Arciaga. Arciaga unable to get ahead on the ball. Good challenge that time by Hudson Rogers. Ball won by the International Tigers. Here comes Esquinuela. Number 4 to number 21, Septian. Ball intercepted. Ball intercepted by Martinez. You have Alfopa. Alfopa plays the ball to space. Martinez with the run on. That's Esquinuela sending the ball out. Takes that chance away. Good job of playing the ball to space to get him out. We do have a substitute coming in.
It is number 25. That's Andrew Ward. And coming off is Alfopa on this near side. Rounding the corner now.
Continues to send his strikers forward. Here comes number 22. The Dallas First Baptist has brought everyone back in the defensive end. Dallas International tries to keep it on their offensive third. Number 29, Garza, looks to clear. Unable to get the ball out. Here comes Herbard. Herbard looks towards Ward. He comes back. Good job that time on the defense by number 5, Arciaga. Ward, very active since he's entered now. He gets the ball. Hudson Rogers retreats, 22. That's going to be Gonzalez. He sends the ball deep. Ball cleared by Salee.
21 Septian is going over to throw it.
11 minutes and 45 seconds remaining in regulation. 11:45 remaining in regulation here at the Taps Fall Soccer Championships. We're tied 1-1, the Crusaders and the Tigers.
Got another throw here for First Baptist. It is once again Septian on the ball.
Ball played forward. Good intercept that time by Herbard. Contact continues. It's a well-challenged game. Referee says play on. Able to turn. Dallas International. Flag stays down. He's onside. This is going to be Andrew Ward. Keeper comes out with the kick save. 19 needs to control. Behar does a good job of driving that ball out wide. Another kick. Navarre in the way. Number five that time. Arciaga clears. Defensemen are playing excellent today to protect their keeper. Valenzuela went down with the kick save. Good job that time of Navarre to finally clear. Gonzalez and Arciaga trying to track down. This time picked up by number eight, Navarre. Navarre makes the turn. He controls to Septian. Septian looks to space to see if he can get it through. Almost got it through tomorrow. Good job that time on defense.
This will be a throw-in for First Baptist. It is Gonzalez throwing it into Amaro.
That was number seven, Levi Mamon giving chase. They tried to center. It's a one-man attack, finally cleared by Hudson Rogers ahead. Chia able to win the battle there. Andrew Ward and Chia. Ball finally cleared to the outside by Escanuela. It's definitely been a two-pronged attack.
Definitely has been. Combination of Chia, Ward, and Alpopo, whichever two are on the field, those two are always going 100% towards the goal at all times.
That's Hudson Rogers with the throw to Martinez. Martinez looks to clear. Last time he went to space for his teammate. This time he'll dribble down lower himself. He makes the turn, able to get the ball towards the middle, but Valenzuela picks up the errant shot. Ward and Chia were both giving chase. They were both making a run on. He looks to turn the field to Amaro. Valenzuela does get the ball to Amaro, looking to Gonzalez. Again, Dallas International School, 9:15 remaining in the second half. 9:15 remaining in a 1-1 tie. This is number 19. This is going to be Kolas Augudo. Sends the ball in deep. He had 25, Ward. Flag was up.
Flag went up.
Keeper made the save, but the flag was up. Ward stays down momentarily.
Ward,
they have been relentless, Will. They continue to attack one-on-one.
Dallas International does not want this game going to overtime. Both of these teams played overtime yesterday, one of which finished in overtime, one of which went to penalties. I'm sure they're just ready to finish this game in regulation.
8:40 remaining in our championship contest. We're all tied at one apiece. Escanuela sends it into play. He's looking for Gonzalez. Herbard in the middle. That's number 10. Takes control. That's Arminio. We have an attack by Martinez. We look onside. He finds Chia. Chia continues with the ball. Good defense that time by number five, Arciaga. And that's number 10, Bennett Chia. Bennett Chia with the score. 8:20 remaining in our contest. Dallas International 2. First Baptist 1.
There were a couple substitutes for Dallas International after that goal, one of which was the goal scorer, Bennett Chia, along with Andrew Ward coming off.
Anna Castanellos enters the pitch for Dallas International. Not sure who the other sub was. First Baptist now aggressive. Garza comes up. They sent their whole defense up front. Ball sent back to this side. Arciaga moves the ball forward.
The other substitute come in was Afopa. He is back on the field now.
Number 19, Behar sends the ball in deep. Amaro tries to control. Amaro driving to the middle.
Looking
for a whistle. Looks like he's got it. 7:41, clock stops with 7:39 remaining here in the second half as we set play. Referee's having a brief discussion. A yellow card is given to number 12. That's Martinez. A quick booking there.
And some more talking.
As he's booked, he'll have to come off the field. Look who's I can't see who's coming on. Will, can you see the number?
It appears to be number 19 or 18. Number 18.
Number 18 is going to be Spencer Gray. He was active when he was in earlier.
He had a big game yesterday. Had a lot of good stops on defense. Controlled the ball well.
21 Septian with the shot. See if he goes to the shot or goes for a pass. He has number 10 Zerminio in the middle. He goes high. Dallas International defense was up to the task. Amaro gives chase. Ball played high. 7:30 remaining in the contest. 7:30 remaining in today's contest. Whistle again blows, but it'll be Dallas International possession. First Baptist scrambling. They need to attack every ball at this point. 7:17 remaining in this contest. First Baptist down 1-2. Dallas International Tigers leading this contest with 7 minutes remaining. Ball put into play. Comes straight down the middle. Garza went up. And Arciaga. This is going to be Navarre on the challenge. Navarre tried to play forward, but Hudson Rogers was there. Another whistle blows. See if Septian gets another chance or if they go this side with Escanuela. I think I'd go Escanuela number 4. He's got a powerful boot. Is that who's going to take it, Will? Can you see?
Yes, that is Escanuela on the ball.
Escanuela on the ball.
Navarre seems to be hobbling a little bit.
Keener, the keeper, seems ready. Ball sent high and wide. He's going back post. Good defense that time.
Good clearance there by the Tigers.
We're down to 6:15 remaining. Amaro's calling for the ball. They went that way, but he was unable to catch up.
And it will go for a goal kick with 6:10 left in this game.
First Baptist continues to push up. They've got their defense all the way up. Let's see what they can do. Dallas International's passes have been pretty good today. They've gone boot to boot more than not, and they play to space well. I think I might play it to the far side into space and let Hudson Rogers and his teammate do their work over there, but they come straight down the middle.
So with as well,
that ball went in to Emma McGregor, number 22. Ball's turned. There's Behar sending the ball back down deep. He was looking for number 10. Unable to find Zerminio. Zerminio now moving forward. He finds Maimon. Maimon plays forward. This is Alfopa.
Ball cleared out by number 19. That was Behar.
We're down to 5:15 remaining in the contest. 5:15 remaining in our championship contest. Throw-in, Dallas International Tigers. Ball thrown short to Alfopa. Behar with his head on ball. Dallas First Baptist wins. Amaro with the ball moving forward. Sends the ball deep and into the middle looking for Arciaga. Referee says play on. There was contact, but he says play on. Ball sent again looking for Amaro. Headed forward by the Tigers. Ball's played good. We just continue in the air. Hadn't been brought to ground yet. Finally, Navarre says, I'll give it a shot, but it sails out of bounds wide for him. 4 minutes and 40 seconds remaining. 4:40 remaining here in the second half. Throw in, Dallas International Tigers, number 19. Number 19 is going to be Colas Augudo. He was looking for his teammate up front. Unable to get it. Tariq Salee sends the ball out. Oh, unable to be corralled by number 19, Behar. It was headed out, but Behar tried to make the stop. Now it'll be a throw in by Dallas International. 4:15 remaining in our contest. 4:15 remaining. Dallas International won. First Baptist 1, Dallas International 2, apologize. Escuela goes forward to 21 Septian. Septian turns it to Arciaga. Arciaga turns it back to Zerminio. Zerminio unable to get his pass through. Good job that time by Emma McGregor. Emma McGregor sends it forward. Now here comes Alfopa. Alfopa with Garza giving charge. Alfopa, Garza, Alfopa controls. Alfopa controls in the corner. He's willing to eat up a little time here. Ball goes out off of Alfopa. First Baptist needs to mount a charge here as the clock is not their friend with 3:30 remaining. 3:30 remaining in our contest. Esquinella sets the ball. Esquinella looking forward. He sends the ball this time looking for number 5, Arciaga. Good pickup that time by the Tigers, number 11. McGregor was also giving chase. 11 again. He's got Alfopa. Alfopa is onside. Takeaway that time. Here comes Navarre. Navarre going up the far sideline. He's looking for Amaro. He's able to get the ball through. Good chase given by Maimon. Maimon, they let the ball almost sail out. It does not. Amaro wins the ball. He centers. Sent the ball to Arciaga. Ball goes in for a shot. Unable to get the ball on goal. Ball comes out high. Ball goes out. It's going to be First Baptist ball. They need to make this play. We're down to 2:45 remaining in the contest. 2:45 remaining in our championship contest. First Baptist needs to look for that shot. They need to find that equalizer. Good turn that time. Ball sent in high. It's there. It's in front of the goal and cleared by the defense. The keeper misjudged the ball. The ball went over his head and his defenders cleared. We're down to 2:26 remaining in the second half. First Baptist had an excellent opportunity to find that equalizer, unable to capitalize. It's going to be a throw-in for Dallas International School. Throw-in with 2:15 remaining in the contest. Substitutes for Dallas International next time possible.
Was back to Garza.
Garza needs to clear. McGregor and Garza. Ball is won by Alfopa. Esquinella had to come send the ball out. Not what he wanted to do in that part. He wanted to keep it in that offensive end. 1:45 remaining. 1:45 remaining in the contest.
This is Martinez coming back on.
McGregor leaving. They're going to take their time, I would imagine. 1:35 remaining in this game. 1:35, they throw back. Ball sent forward. Alfopa was on the run. Behar unable to corral. They don't have time to be kicking the ball out. They're going to have to take some chances here. They chase the ball quickly. It's going to be 1:20 remaining in our contest. 1:20 remaining in this championship contest. Ball being thrown in by number 19. That's Colas Augudo. Augudo throws the ball, goes back out again. We're almost to a minute to play. We're down to 60 seconds of play. Dallas International School and their offensive end hold the lead 2-1. 2-1, Tigers over the Crusaders. The Crusaders coming forward. They need this atop. They need the ball. Navarre wins the ball. 45 seconds remaining. He plays forward to Amaro. Amaro unable to control. Dallas International continues their attack.
Martinez looking for a
ball shot. Comes straight on through. Might have been the best thing that could have happened for First Baptist because Valenzuela with the punt. He looks ahead to Arciaga. Arciaga gets his head on the ball. They're unable to attack, unable to bring the ball to ground. Navarre now plays forward. Navarre plays wide to Behar. Behar sends the ball forward. Intercepted by Dallas International. Ball played high. 15 seconds remaining in the contest. Time for one last push. Dallas International with the throw in. With 10 seconds remaining, they may not even have to put the ball back in play. They do put the ball in play as the clock expires. Dallas International Tigers, Fall Soccer 2019 champions. Dallas International Tigers 2. The ambassadors of First Baptist Brownsville 1. Thank you for joining us here on Taps TV. We'll be back momentarily as we present our all-tournament and our awards for both teams on an excellently played game, excellent seasons by both teams. Thank you for joining us here on Taps TV.
We will be getting started here with the awards in just a few moments as we get our awards down to the field, get our two teams together. So we'll be conducting our awards here soon. Thank you for staying tuned here on Taps TV for the 2019 Fall Soccer Championship. So as we get the two teams over here, we will be first announcing the all-tournament team from the four teams and then conducting to the runner-up and our champions. We will be going through all-tournament here in just a few moments as we finish getting the teams over.
Tournament team for 2019.
The all-tournament team.
Number one, Nahum Nieto.
From Presbyterian Pan-American, Nahum Nieto and Calvin Lamb.
Jacob Owen.
From Bethesda Christian, Jacob Owen and Lucas Johnston. Jacob Owen and Lucas Johnston are still here. They're walking up now to get their all-tournament medals. Congratulations to those two from Bethesda.
Carlos Amaro.
From First Baptist, Carlos Amaro.
From Dallas International, David Martinez.
From Dallas International, David Martinez.
From First Baptist, Luis Arciaga.
From First Baptist, Luis Arciaga. From Dallas International, Charles Hebrard. From First Baptist, Flavio Zerminio. From Dallas International, Arthur Algudo.
First Baptist, Mauricio Valenzuela.
From First Baptist, Mauricio Valenzuela.
And from Dallas International,
Pierrick Afopa. This is your TAPS 2019 All-Tournament Team. Congratulations to First Baptist School of Brownsville. They are here as the runners-up now. Congratulations to them. And the team is number 2, Raul Rodriguez. Number 3, Elian De Los Santos.
Number 4, Enrique Esquinela.
Number 4, Enrique Esquinela.
Number 5, Cesar Arciaga.
Number 5, Cesar Arciaga.
Number 6, Luis Arciaga.
Number 6, Luis Arciaga.
Number 7, Pedro Silva.
Number 7, Pedro Silva. Number 8, Aldo Navarre.
Number 9, Octavio Gomez.
Number 9, Octavio Gomez.
Number 10, Flavio Zerminio.
Number 10, Flavio Zerminio.
Number 12, Jorge Ladron.
Number 12, Jorge Ladron. Number 14, Blanca Pinaloza.
Number 15, Victor Rivera.
Number 15, Victor Rivera.
Number 16, Carlos Amaro.
Number 16, Carlos Amaro.
Number 17, Esteban Cavazos.
Number 17, Esteban Cavazos.
Number 18, Gabriel Cervantes.
Number 18, Gabriel Cervantes. Number 19, Daniel Behar.
Number 21, Edgar Septian.
Number 21, Edgar Septian.
Number 22, Jose Gonzalez.
Number 22, Jose Gonzalez.
Number 23, Ati Gomez.
Number 23, Ati Gomez.
Number 26, John McEachern.
Number 26, John McEachern. Number 28, Maximo Quintanilla.
Number 29, Rolando Garza.
Number 29, Rolando Garza.
And the keeper, Mauricio Valenzuela.
And your goalkeeper, Mauricio Valenzuela.
Congratulations, First Baptist,
First Baptist Academy from Brownsville for being the runners-up for the 2019 TAPS Fall Soccer Championship. And now for your champions of the 2019 TAPS Fall Soccer Championship from Dallas International School and the Tigers. Number one, your goalkeeper, Jordan Keener.
Number 2, Simone Floden.
Number 2, Simone Floden.
Number 3, Joseph Deshin.
Number 3, Joseph Deshin. Number 4, Hudson Rogers.
Number 5, Christopher Granberry.
Number 5, Christopher Granberry.
Number 6, Arthur Algudo.
Number 6, Arthur Algudo.
Number 7, Levi Maimond.
Number 7, Levi Maimond.
Number 8, Tariq Salih.
Number 8, Tariq Salih. Number 9, Charles Hebrard.
Number 10, Bennett Chia.
Number 10, Bennett Chia. Number 11, Edward Ulbricht.
Number 12, David Martinez.
Number 12, David Martinez.
Number 13, Anna Castellanos.
Number 13, Anna Castellanos.
Number 15, Pierre Alfopa.
Number 15, Pierre Alfopa.
Number 18, Spencer Gray.
Number 18, Spencer Gray. Number 19, Kolos Algudo.
Number 20, Eduardo Silva.
Number 20, Eduardo Silva.
Number 21, Enzo McGregor.
Number 21, Enzo McGregor.
Number 22, Emma McGregor.
Number 22, Emma McGregor. And number 25, Andrew Ward. Congratulations to the Dallas International School on this.
Tristan Stock rounds out the roster.
Congratulations to Dallas International School, the Tigers. They have won. They are the champions of the 2019 Fall Soccer Championship. Thank you for joining us today on TAPS TV for the Fall Soccer Championships. We look forward to seeing you again at our next event, which will be volleyball at the end of next week. Until then, thank you for watching TAPS TV. Goodbye, everyone.